Focus indicators play a crucial role in providing visual feedback to users when interacting with different elements on a web page. Implemented through CSS pseudo-classes like Focus, Focus Within, and Focus Visible, these indicators enhance usability and accessibility. In this video, we will explore each of these pseudo-classes, demonstrating how they work and why they're important for creating an accessible and user-friendly website. Before we begin, remember to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't already to stay updated on our web development tutorials. Let's dive in. We have a very basic web page showcasing a page title, a brief paragraph, and a simple contact form. The form includes standard input fields and a submit button. In addition, we have applied some foundational styles for the page layout and the arrangement of the form elements. These styles mainly define attributes such as font sizes, colors, background colors, and other basic aspects of the design. Now, let's understand what focus indicators are and why they're important for a website. When we interact with the links or form elements on a web page, a default outline appears around the element. You'll notice a blue-colored border-like shape showing up when we click on the input field. This same effect occurs when we use the keyboard, rather than using a mouse click to switch between elements. These outlines are known as focus indicators or focus rings. They serve as visual markers that indicate which element on a web page is currently focused. It's important to note that only one element on a page can be focused on at a time, and it should be obvious which one that is. The primary purpose of a focus indicator is to provide essential visual feedback for users who don't navigate websites using a mouse. This includes individuals with vision-related disabilities who rely on screen readers to interpret web page content, those with mobility impairments who cannot use a mouse and depend on keyboard navigation, as well as power users like web developers who prefer keyboard shortcuts for efficiency. Developers often encounter challenges in styling form elements to align with website aesthetics while maintaining accessibility. While default focus outlines may not always fit design preferences, many web developers opt to remove them, which leads to usability issues for keyboard users. Sometimes, we opt to use a regular border as a substitute for outlines. While this does provide visual indications, it can introduce other issues to the web page. For example, adding a border may cause the layout to shift slightly. Noticed? The input fields in this case jump slightly from their original position. Though this can be fixed by adding a transparent border for the normal state, why make things complicated when we already have a better solution readily available? Utilizing the outline CSS property offers a versatile solution. This property enables precise control over focus indicators' appearance without compromising layout integrity, ensuring both visual appeal and accessibility. This serves as a shorthand for setting up different outline properties in a single declaration. It includes outline width, outline style, and outline color, offering greater flexibility in styling focus indicators. It also offers convenient keywords such as thin, medium, or thick for defining the width of the outline, and various styles like double, dotted, dashed, and more for customizing its appearance. Additionally, the outline offset property makes it easy to specify the distance between an outline and the edge of an element. This feature allows for precise control over the spacing of the outline, ensuring optimal visual presentation without impacting the layout of the web page. In this case, we're instructing the outline to maintain a 4-pixel gap from its associated element. Interestingly, applying a negative value would position the outline inside the element, which can be used to achieve unique visual effects. Now let's explore the Focus Within pseudo-class. By definition, the Focus Within pseudo-class targets an element if the element itself or any of its descendants are currently being focused. In simple words, it represents an element that is itself or has any of its children indicated by the Focus pseudo-class. A straightforward use case of the Focus Within pseudo-class is to style our form when any of its input fields or the button is being focused. It adds a border to the entire form if any of its children are in focus. This simple solution can be used to assist with the form validations. For instance, we can assign a red background color to indicate errors and a green color for success. Moreover, we can utilize a combination of CSS rules to dynamically style the form based on the user interaction, enhancing the overall user experience and providing clear visual feedback during form submission and validation. We have a dedicated video showcasing how to utilize the Focus Within Pseudo-Class to create an expandable search bar. Feel free to check that out for further insights. Then comes the Focus Visible Pseudo-Class, which is the latest addition for creating a focus indicator. This pseudo-class applies when an element matches the Focus Pseudo-Class, and the browser determines that the focus should be made evident on the element. Essentially, Focus Visible functions similarly to the Focus Pseudo-Class, but it triggers only when it would be most beneficial for the user. Let's go through our form once again. When utilizing the Focus Pseudo-Class, the outline is displayed no matter if we use the keyboard or the mouse to navigate between elements. It is logical to display a visual indicator when an input element is in focus or when a keyboard is being used. But when we use the mouse to click a button, it becomes obvious that we already know which element we have clicked, and showing a focus indicator in such cases doesn't provide any additional value. That's why modern browsers started using the Focus Visible Pseudo-Class, selectively applying focus styles only when they are most useful for users. Therefore, opting for the Focus Visible over the traditional Focus Pseudo-Class is increasingly recommended. Now, with the Focus Visible applied, every form element, including the button, will display the focus indicator when navigating with the keyboard. However, when using a mouse, only input fields will indicate focus, while the button will not generate any type of indication. This selective approach ensures that focus indicators are only shown when truly necessary, contributing to a cleaner and more intuitive user experience. To accommodate older browser versions that do not support the Focus Visible Pseudo-Class, we can employ the @supports rule. This rule allows us to check if a browser supports a certain feature before applying styles. In this case, we can define a fallback using the Focus Pseudo-Class. A basic guideline for the accessible design is that if you can interact with an element with the mouse, you should also be able to do the same thing using just the keyboard. And if you're using the keyboard, anything you interact with should show a focus indicator. Implementing these visual indicators improves accessibility, ensuring that users who rely on keyboard navigation can easily understand and navigate through the site. Providing clear visual feedback also improves the overall user experience by helping users understand the context of their interactions. If you found this explanation helpful, feel free to share your suggestions or feedback in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to stay updated on upcoming web development tutorials. Thanks for watching.